We'll be underway momentarily with BayHawks basketball. We'll hold it here for the starting lineups and for the national anthem.
The NJCAA Region 29 and BCC are committed to the ideals of good sportsmanship, safety, and fair play. We ask all fans, coaches, and players to show respect for the opposing team, game officials, and each other before, during, and after today's game. For tonight's starters, first, visiting Bunker Hill, number one, Elijah Rogers. Number two, Tron Griffin. Number three, Kevon Young. Number 12, David Stewart. And number 22, Anthony Gilardi. Now for Bristol Community College, the following freshman guard for Protector Rhode Island, number 13, Armani.
And we are just moments from tip-off here at the Bishop Connolly Gymnasium, where the BCC BayHawks are going to take on the BHCC Bulldogs. Now, last season, BCC lost a heartbreaker in the playoffs to the BHCC Bulldogs. Now they come to seek revenge, as we have Jarrell Gomes facing up against number 12, David Stewart. He's a 6'4" forward from Madison Park Voc-Tech. Jarrell Gomes comes from Providence, Rhode Island and Feinstein High School. Much of a size advantage for David Stewart. But BCC gets the tip off. Monty Baker drives in and he gets the charge. Ball's going the other way. Bunker Hill ball. Bunker Hill passes it in. Brings the ball down court. Got another foul on the play. Looks like it's going to be against BCC. And Alex Cotton gets his first foul. Rogers passes it in. Rogers has the ball. Passes across court. Nobody there. Rebounds to number five, Gonzalez. Nelson brings it down. Contos has the ball back to Nelson. Errant pass by Gonzalez, and Bunker Hill recovers the ball and brings it down court. Number three, Kevin Young, drives, dishes to Stewart, who gets blocked by Nelson, steals it back, and it's going to be White. It's going to be BCC basketball. So it goes out on Kevon Young. Nelson tosses it into Gomes. Looking for a man. Tricky dribble, gives it up. Rogers on the other end with two. Gomes tosses it deep, and layup is up and in by Amani Baker. Big three by number two, Tron Griffith, misses, and Baker gets the rebound. Nelson passes it over to Gomes. Gomes to Gonzalez. Gonzalez to Cotton. And Nelson's got the ball. Looks to do something with it. Oop. Gets it knocked away. 2 seconds to shoot. Floats one up and in. What concentration by Nelson to drop that basket with the clock winding down on him. Young passes the ball to Rogers. Rogers passes it in to Giraldi. And Giraldi is going to foul on the play. And a foul on Amani Baker. Picks up his first foul of the game. So far, two team fouls. Ball's in to Young. Young looks to do something with it. Dishes it in low to Stewart. Oh, up and missed. Baker rebounds, gets stripped. And number one, Rogers, puts up two. Gomes brings it down court. Gonzalez has it after the pass. Back to Gomes. Ooh, out of bounds. Going to be White ball off of Elijah Rogers, 5'11 point guard from Brookline High School. Right now we got a 4-4 basketball game with 17:21 left in the first half. Ooh. And we got out of bounds on Anthony Giraldi. Tried to pull away the inbound and dribbled it back out of bounds, giving it back to BCC. Ref giving the team some direction. Passes out deep to Gonzalez. 5 to shoot, dribbles in, tosses up a floater, rebounds it, fresh shot clock, and Baker off the rebound, Gomes off the rebound, up and in for Gomes. Young brings it down. Down low to Stewart. Lays it up and misses it. And it's going to be out of bounds on Stewart. BCC basketball. It's interesting to see. Big man down low. Can't really put up shots. Isn't doing much so far. Baker cherry picking. And call a travel on him. It's going back the other way. BCC ball. Rogers brings it down court. Rogers shoots one up. Nelson's there. Baker with the rebound. Right now BCC playing about kind of like a half-court press on defense. Moving the ball around. Gonzalez has it. Dishes it up and in for two. Scores his first 2 points of the game. Back the other way. Rogers shot it up, missed it. Gomes for three. Nothing too far. Rebound by Giraldi. Griffith brings it down court. dishes it up and misses. Nelson with the rebound knocked out of his hand. Kevon Young finishes it for Bunker Hill. 8-6, BCC holding on to a 2-point lead as Gomes brings it down court. Nelson with the ball behind the line. It's another foul on BCC. Ball's going the other way. They got a block on Jarrell Gomes. So he picks up his first foul of the game. And now it's Bunker Hill ball. Slow going in this first half so far. 5 minutes off the clock. Stewart's got the ball. Passes it and stolen by Nelson, who takes it the other way and puts it up for two. Nelson, 4 points on the game so far. With about 15 minutes left to go, BCC's got a 4-point lead, 10-6. Bunker Hill tries to set the pick. Stewart shoots it up. He gets fouled, and he's going to go to the line for two on that one. And the foul is going to be on number two. Nope. Maybe number 12, Alex Cotton. Checking in for BCC is number 10, Ryan Carter. And number two, if I can find him on here. No, I got him somewhere. Number two, Josh Banks. And Bunker Hill hits both of their free throws. Checking in for Bunker Hill is Franz Francois. The 6'3 guard forward from English High School. Nelson brings it down court. As BCC holds on to a 2-point lead. Banks with the ball. Cross court to Nelson. Gomes looks to do something with it. Dribbles in. Easy layup, but they're going to call a travel. So travel on Gomes. BCC ball. It's getting the BCC crowd fired up on that call. Rogers brings it down, hoping to tie up this ball game. And instead, they take a 1-point lead with a three. 11-10, Bunker Hill has the lead. Nelson shoots it mid-range and hits it. BCC takes a 1-point lead now. And it's going to be a turnover, BCC basketball. Checking in for BCC, Miguel Tejada. And taking a break is going to be Alex Cotton. And Tejada will get right in, inbound it to Nelson. Nelson with the basketball. Trying to make his way inside, dishes it to Gonzalez. To three, no dice. Rebound, Kevon Young. Oop. Gonna be a shooting foul. On Tejada, so Tejada checks in and racks up his first foul already. And Franz Francois off the bench is gonna shoot two. If he hits both, he'll give Bunker Hill the lead. Crowd tries to get into his head, and they are successful as he misses his first free throw. BCC already racking up five fouls on the game. They're one away from the bonus with 13:51 left to go in the game and a tie ball game. So they need to be careful before they get themselves in foul trouble. Santel Rodriguez has checked into the game. He was the one bringing the ball down court. Right now we've got Carter passing back to Banks. Banks dribbles over. Oh, Rodriguez with the ball. Five to shoot. Little layup, and it's good. Coming in 2 points off the bench for Dontell Rodriguez. Rodgers brings it up court. Looks to do something with it. Quick dish to Grimaldi, who got shut down. But that ball is going to stay on this side. But a nice block by Jarrell Gomes on that play. Bunker Hill takes a timeout. With 13:10 left in the game, BCC holding on to a 2-point lead. It's interesting to see so far with a team like Bunker Hill, where they have a little bit more size compared to BCC, that the game is this close. But both teams playing a very evenly matched basketball game right now. It's interesting to see who can play the most level-headed game, keep themselves out of A foul trouble, and B, turn over the ball. Less turnovers, less foul trouble. Better chance of winning the basketball game. So right now on the floor for BCC is Jarrell Gomes, Josh Banks, Dontell Rodriguez, Miguel Tejada, and Ryan Carter. For Bunker Hill, we have Elijah Rogers, John Griffith, Kevon Young, Franz Francois, and Anthony Giraldi. And that was Kevon Young with the shot and the three-pointer for a 1-point lead. And checking in for Bunker Hill is number 12, David Stewart. Number 13, Sean Miller, 5'8 guard, freshman from English High School as well. So Francois and Sean Miller have actually played basketball together before here. They played in high school together as well. Rodriguez dribbles in right down the lane. Oh, he can't put it away. Rebound Young, and on the transition with the and the charge. Thought he was gonna get the shooting foul, but instead he got an offensive foul and a charge, and it's BCC basketball. Going to go back the other way after he tosses it up and catches it. That's out of bounds. BCC turnover back to Bunker Hill now. And it's silly plays like this. You can't have plays where, you know, luck goes your way, you pick up the charge foul, get the ball back, and then turn it right back over. No way to get an advantage. Young thinks about a three. Second guesses himself. Blocked by Tejada. Rodriguez on the transition. Easy up and in for two. What a play. And Rodriguez has 4 points on this game so far. Out deep for the three, off the rim is Young. And BCC ball once again. With a 1-point lead, 12:20 left to go in this game. BCC 16, Bunker Hill 15. Checking in for the Bayhawks is Nelson, and Gomes is gonna take a break. So now we're getting these flip-flop back-and-forth turnovers. Let's see who can settle down and keep the ball in their hands. As Rodriguez brings it down court for the Bayhawks. Battling with his defender. Banks down low. Oh, almost an easy up and in, but not enough on it. As Rodgers brings it down, dishes it to Stewart. Stewart loses control. And Elijah Rogers with a nice layup. 6 points on this game so far for Rogers. Banks with the ball. Banks gets robbed in the lane. And here comes Young up and in for an easy two and a foul. And he can give his team a 4-point lead on that. Now he's going to go to the line for one. It's tough to see something like that. You can't really drive the lane when you have an uneven matchup, three in the paint, and you go in, you're bound to get robbed. But no good on the extra shot. Rodriguez takes it the other way and misses it. He pass, keeps it alive, back to Banks. Nelson has it now. Battling with his man. Out of bounds, BCC. Nelson attempted to pass it, and Lewis Carter wasn't ready for that pass. So now you got Young bringing it down. Tries the easy layup, misses it. Nelson with the quick layup, and Banks on the transition shot, good for two, and he puts down his first 2 points of the game so far. BCC down by one, 11:02 to go in this first half. Young's got the ball. This is to number 13, Sean Miller. He gets the lucky spin, and he's gonna go to the line for one more. And that foul on Banks. I think that's his first foul of the game. And Miller's gonna go to the line for two. Checking into the game for Bunker Hill is Ivan De La Cruz. He's a 5'8 point guard, freshman from Shenandoah Valley Academy in Virginia. They made a bit of a trip to come to Bunker Hill. He misses his free throw. Gonzalez with the rebound. Jordan. Rodriguez mid-range. Makes it look easy. Puts a 6 point on the board. Oh. Nelson with the steal. All the way back. Can't finish. Dishes it back out. Easy shot by Roderick. Puts up his 8 points now. With 10 minutes to go and a 1 point lead for BCC. So you see the lead change hands at least 3-4 times in this game, as they are playing a very evenly matched basketball game. We're gonna call a kickball on BCC. And ball's gonna stay on the side of the court. Throwing the ball in is Zachary Badua, a 6'3 guard forward from New Mission High School. Tosses it in to Rogers. Stewart's gonna try and make something of it. Big man in the paint, hasn't been able to do much so far this game. And that luck continues. Gets the ball robbed from him by Gonzalez. Carter takes it the other way, and it's good for two. Ryan Carter putting up his first 2 points of the game as well. And we got a 24-21 3-point BCC lead with 9:38 left in this first half. Rogers drives up and in, good for two. And he's got 8 points on this game so far. Bones all the way, tries to dunk, but the rim shuts him down. And that's why sometimes pretty ain't good. That's a trip. Oh, it's a travel. BCC basketball, lucky play there. Should have probably been a foul for the trip there. But a 24-23, 1 point BCC lead with about 9 minutes to go. Rodriguez brings it into Carter, shoots a three, misses, ball bounces around. Gonzalez finally gets the rebound. He's hotly contested by Rogers. He drives it back in for two. Makes it look easy. He's got 4 points on the game now. Poked away off the hands of Bunker Hill, and that's BCC basketball. It's a ball and a 3-point lead with 8:45 left to go in this game. Rodericks throws it in to Nelson. Nelson looking for an open man, has Gomes low. Gomes passes it out deep. Carter with the easy three and no dice. Rodriguez gets the ball back. Gomes up and in. Two and the foul. What a play by Jarrell Gomes. He gets that ball in low. Battles with man. He's going to go to the line for one more. Fouls on number 20, Zachary Badua. And checking in for BCC is Chitty Amici, and Carter's gonna take a break. So Gomes is to the line to shoot one after he hits the basket. And he misses it, so BCC holds on to a 5-point lead. Those dishes over to Padua. Rogers takes three. Ref calls a foul. Nelson gets the hold, so Anthony Giraldi is going to shoot two. Giraldi is a 6'4 forward guard from Melrose High School. Shoots and misses. Nelson gets the rebound. Brings it back down court. Shoots a two just inside the line, and he nails it. And he racks up his 8th point of the game. BCC now has a 7-point lead as Rogers tries to make something of it. Giraldi down low, off the edge of the basketball. The backboard. Rodriguez dishes it back to Jordan. He brings it up, and he gets two and the foul. 10 points in the game so far for Joshua Nelson. Sorry, I called him Jordan before. Josh Nelson, 10 points in the game so far, and he's gonna shoot one more. Nelson gets one shot here after he sinks the basket and gets the foul. All is quiet in the gymnasium. And he misses. Rebound by Zachary Bedua. Rogers brings it down court. Dishes out to number 13, Sean Miller. Sean Miller can't hit it. They get the rebound, they get the ball back. Bedua shoots one up from a mile away and misses. Rebound, BCC. Rodriguez brings it up slow, waits for the offense to get set. Tries to drive it in. Errant pass gets stolen by Bedua. Number 5, Ivan De La Cruz brings it back a little bit. Dishes it back to Bedua, and he gets it for two. And we got a timeout on the court. Timeout by... BCC takes a 30-second timeout with 7:03 left in this game. So far, Josh Nelson and Dontel Rodriguez have been the top scorers for your BCC basketball team. Elijah Rogers for Bunker Hills put up 8 points so far. I'll be honest now, I haven't kept good, solid track of their points because now they've scored a little bit more than the 20 points I have down here. Amici almost hits his first basket of the game, but instead Bunker Hill brings it back down. It's number 2, Tron Griffith, trying to hit the 3, but he can't. Rebound, Jarrell Gomes. Gomes brings it down the court, dishes to Amici. Banks the 3. Oh, rattles the rim in and out. Griffith with the rebound, bringing it back up court. Gomes with the steal on an errant pass by Griffith. Tries to bounce it back around his back. He loses control of the ball. Now, he got an easy layup for Ivan De La Cruz, and he's going to go to the line for two. Thank you. Harper's at the line to shoot one. He hits it and makes it a 4-point game. 32-28, BCC has a lead with 6:11 to go. Gomes dishes over to Amici. Gomes almost with the double dribble. Amici for three, little too far. Young brings it down court. Miller for three, money. Miller gets his first points of the game in the form of a three-pointer. BCC holds on to a one-point lead. Ball's in, Gonzalez brings it down. He's got 4 points so far in this game. Holmes has the ball, he's got 4 points as well. Wow. Carter hits the three and he makes it look easy. Give BCC a 4-point basketball game. 4-point lead in the basketball game, I should say. Stewart down low, up and not in. Down low again, he misses it again. And we're gonna have a foul. Offensive foul is gonna be a charge. Banks is gonna sit and Rodriguez checks back in. 5:21 left to go, BCC ball and a 4-point lead. Carter for another three, can't get it. Gonzalez with the rebound, almost gets robbed. Amici's got the ball. Rodriguez tries to shoot three, but he thinks better of it. Carter thinks about it again. Rodriguez does it this time, and he can't let it sink. Griffith with the rebound. Young bringing it back. Fall down three is missed, BCC ball. Rodriguez on the transition. He hits two, and he has 10 points on the game as well. It's amazing to see the BCC basketball team just flowing up and down the court, scoring baskets at a high rate of speed. They get another charge, another turnover, and it's BCC's ball again with 4:33 left in the game and a 6-point lead. BCC just firing on all cylinders right now. They are actually one foul away from hitting the double bonus. But with 4:33 left to go, they've really settled down from some of their early foul troubles. And they are making Bunker Hill pay with their readiness for the plays, their readiness for the drives, and they're reacting quickly. Goes for two, and it's good. He racks up his 6th point of the game. And we got a 39-31 game, 4:19. Bunker Hill calls a timeout. Take a 30-second timeout. Checking in for BCC after the timeout. It's going to be number 13. I'm trying to find on my magical paper. And Jeremiah Ephraim. Saw him last game. He was actually a very big contributor last game. Making a lot of important baskets and really carrying the team in a game where they spent most of it behind and most of it battling back. And except for a couple of silly plays, a la the dunk by Gomes that got rejected by the rim this game. We had, if I remember right, it was Josh Banks who tried to hit a dunk when they were down by 12. He didn't hit it, turned the ball over, and it was a time like that last game where you couldn't have a silly play like that. But we are back in action with this game, 4:19 to go, Bunker Hill ball. As Elijah Rogers brings it back across court. He's a 5'11 point guard from Brookline High School. He shoots three, and he sinks three. He makes it look easy. He's got 11 points in this game so far. Ephraim's got the ball. Rogers dishes it across to Carter. Carter inside to Gomes. Ephraim down low, and he almost sinks the two, but it's rebounded by Stewart. Oop, gonna be, not sure what the call was there. So Rodericks gets the foul, and it's gonna bring Rogers to the line for two because BCC is now in the double bonus. So for the next 3 minutes and 44 seconds, every foul that BCC racks up, Bunker Hill will go to the line for two. Which is not good in a 5-point game. Rogers makes the first one. He's going to try and shoot a second one. Crowd tries to get into his head as he shoots a second free throw. And they are unsuccessful as he hits two. So he now has 13 points in this game so far. Rodriguez brings the ball down. BCC moving the ball with ease around the court. Just inside the line, Gonzalez misses it. Stewart gets the rebound. And the foul's gonna be on Stewart. After he, foul's gonna be on David Stewart. He gets the hold. As he tried to battle him for the ball, he hooked him around and threw him down. He shoots one and one. But no, they thought he was going to shoot one and one, but the foul wasn't on the shot. So BCC basketball, though, fresh shot clock with 3:27 left to go and a 3-point lead. Stewart getting frustrated. He hasn't been able to produce much. Had a lot of shots right under the basket that he hasn't hit. And now he gets racks up another foul. As Rogers pleads Stewart's case with the ref. If we've already seen a technical called on BCC a couple games ago, Bunker Hill doesn't want to talk their way into one as well. Gonzalez with the ball, over to Rodriguez. And they're calling a block. Foul. He racks up two fouls in a very quick amount of time. BCC will shoot one and one. And it's gotta be frustrating for Bunker Hill to be racking up foul on foul on foul so quickly. They're two fouls away from BCC being in the double bonus. And we still have 3.5 minutes to go in this half. 20 seconds, they've racked up upwards of three fouls. Rodriguez hits the first one. Now he's going to shoot one more. All quiet in the gymnasium as Rodriguez shoots the second one. And he hits it. He's good for two. And he's good for a 5-point BCC lead. Rodgers brings it down, deep to Zabadua. I'm sorry, Zach Badua. He dishes it up and in for two, and we got 3 points on the game. 3-point lead for BCC, I should say. Ephraim, errant pass, which Gomes is gonna be able to recover, but it's gonna be a backcourt violation. It's gonna be Bunker Hill ball. He really had no choice in that matter because it was either, wait till he touched. Coach Delalue must be a little frustrated with a play like that. Errant passing is not something you want during a basketball game. But you do want a block like that. And Ephraim, on the transition, can't convert. Rogers brings it back down. See if he can get two more. Almost, but not quite. And a foul on BCC. Gonna send Giraldi to the line. And that foul is going to be on Jarrell Gomes. He's going to pick up his third foul of the game. And Giraldi's going to shoot one. He's going to shoot two, actually, because we're in the double bonus. And he hits the first one, making a 2-point basketball game with 2:32 left to go. BCC 41, BHCC 39. Shoots gets the second one, and he misses the second one. Gomes with the rebound, dishes it back to Vadua, who sends it back to Rogers, who shoots three and misses. Gomes with the rebound, loses it again. Vadua gets it back again. He shoots two and the foul. So Gonzalez gets the blocking foul. Vadua gets the points, and he's going to shoot one more. With 2:16 left to go, we have a tie ball game. And Bunker Hill can't take the lead. And Coach Delalue takes time out so he can regroup and get their heads back in the game. So right now we got Cody Hendricks and Alex Cotton checking into the game. Alex, two fouls on the game so far, no points. But I think he has 2 points on this game so far. I think I'm lying. But he does have two fouls so far. He's going to check back in for a little bit. Coach Delalue trying to rally the troops, basically telling them, when you get the ball, hold on to it for a second, see what you got, then pass it. Don't just try and pass it to anybody and then turn it over. Very close basketball game right now. You got a tie game. You got to shoot one. It's a team that you played before. You've lost a heartbreaker two before. You don't want to do it again, especially after losing a hard-fought game last Thursday. With that timeout over, BCC readies themselves for the rebound on this free throw by Badua. He shoots, and he hits it. Oh, one more. He's got 9 points on this game so far. Trigas brings it down court, crosses half court. Carter, cross court pass intercepted. That was a lackadaisical pass. I could see that was going to make it from here. And Bunker Hill's got the ball back. Miller on the other end. Three, no go. Rodriguez gets the rebound. He brings it back down court. He's just been all over the court today with a falling, twisting shot. He misses. BCC gets the rebound. Carter gets the ball. BCC needs to, I think, take a breath, settle down for a second, regroup. They got 20 on the shot clock. We don't need to act too wild about it now. We're down by one. Game's still rolling here. Kick ball, BCC ball. Amici checks in for Rodriguez. Amici throws it in. 1:30 left to go in the game. Cotton, unaware, gets the ball stolen from him. Rogers with an amazing pinwheel pass back to Griffith, who can't convert. Hendricks brings the ball back down court. Ricci's got the ball, passes it back to Hendricks. Floater from the middle. He misses it. And Bunker Hill ball. Rogers with it. Drives the lane. Dishes to Badu. Badu for two. He's got 11 points on this game so far. And they have a 3-point lead with just 30 on the clock. Got a 3-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. They're going to run it down, try and get that last shot off. Head into the locker room, hopefully, with a tie ball game. Plays like that, not going to happen too well. And errant passing is going to be the death of them. Rogers misses the shot. Fouls on Carter. And that means they'll go to the line for two. Another silly foul for them. Sends Bunker Hill to the line, too. Could be taking a 5-point lead into the locker room. And he shoots the second one and he misses it. And they can't put it back up. BCC's got 1 second to shoot. And they get it slapped right back in their faces. At halftime, BCC has a 4-point deficit. BCC's got 41. The Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs have 45. We're going to take a quick break and come back to you in a few minutes with a quick halftime report. And then after that, we'll bring you back with second half action. You're listening to Fall River Community Media's coverage of Bayhawks basketball. Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Fall River Community Media's coverage of Bayhawks basketball. We are at halftime with a score of Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 45, Bristol Community College Bayhawks 41. First half of this game was a very interesting one. We saw many a lead change. The lead changed hands at least 5-6 times overall. All right, let's go over the numbers real quickly for your BCC Bayhawks. Joshua Nelson was just all over the court, running back and forth, rebounding, stealing, and shooting. He's got 10 points so far in this game. Dontel Rodriguez off the bench as well has put up 12 points so far in this game. He's been all over the court and a difference maker. For Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs, Elijah Rogers, he has 14 points so far in this game. Kevin Young also with 10 points for the Bunker Hill Community College. And Zachary Badu off the bench, 10 points as well. He's been a definite factor in this game so far. Got about 30 seconds till we get back to some basketball. Say the keys to the second half for BCC is to play smart. Don't turn the ball over. Errant passes need to be eliminated. And just keep your head in the game. Keep your eye on the prize. You're only down by 4. You can easily come back and dominate this game. Surprised to see last couple of games, especially a week ago, the game they played against UCAP, University of Connecticut at Avery Point, BCC relied heavily on a full court press defense for almost the entirety of the game. They kept UCAP's back against the wall from 20 minutes in the first half to 5 minutes left in the second half. They haven't played that same defense anymore. They played more of a normal man-to-man defense, zone defense, but interesting to see if they bring that press defense back with this 4-point deficit. For Bunker Hill, they're basically, the keys to their second half are about the same. They can't make mistakes. Can't rack up fouls like they were. You can't rack up 3 fouls in a minute. You gotta play with your, play with some smart. Right now, the ball's in play. Giraldi drives in, shoots 2 and gets it. He gets his 4th point of the game so far. Right now on the court for BCC, we have Jarrell Gomes, we have Steven Gonzalez, we got Josh Nelson, we have Amani Baker, and we have Alex Cotton. Right now on the court for Bunker Hill is Elijah Rogers, Kevon Young, David Stewart, Anthony Giraldi, and I'm missing one guy. Tron Griffith. BCC shot clock runs out on him. And there's a foul on the play. Gomes gets the push. That's his 4th foul of the game so far. And Griffith throws it in. Rogers drives the line, can't get it. Nelson gets the rebound. Ooh, that's going to be a foul on Rogers.
Let's go, Nelson.
and it's going to be BCC basketball. Each team won so foul so far in the beginning stages of the second half. Gomes dribbles down. And Gomes has ball, dishes it to Nelson. Gomes shoots a mid-range jumper, rattles out. Baker with the rebound, but he can't get it to go. Griffith gets the rebound. Rogers, set by Nelson. Gomes battles Young. Stewart, gonna go to the line for two. Shooting foul is gonna be on Cotton. Cotton racks up his third foul of the game. Stewart's gonna shoot two. So far he hasn't scored yet in this game. Could be his first point of the game, and it is. And he hits them both, giving Bunker Hill an 8-point lead. 49-41. Nelson drives the lane, dishes it out to Gonzalez. Gomes has it, hotly contested by Young. Got the double team on him, passes to Baker, who can't get his hands around it, gets stolen. Young dishes to Stewart, who lays it up and in for two more. So he goes from somebody who we didn't hear much about to somebody who we're seeing a lot of in the second half. And BCC calls a timeout with a 10-point deficit now. 17:41 left to go in this second half. So we saw, we're seeing Bunker Hill going a 6-0 run so far in the second half. And BCC just can't seem to stop them. Stewart's starting to get in gear, and they're just firing on all cylinders right now, you know. Coach Dalu rallying the troops. He's not happy with the defense. They're not getting in position in time, and that's why Bunker Hill is having an easy time of scoring on them. Looks like Card is going to check in. Checking on the next whistle. It's going to be BCC basketball with 17:41 left to go. 51-41 lead for Bunker Hill. Holmes with only 7 points so far in this game. Really hasn't been much of a factor. Whereas usually he's a kind of like the glue that holds the team together. Baker gets that basket, but an offensive foul negates it. And it's going to be Bunker Hill ball. So doesn't look like that talk that Coach Delu had with the team sank in too much there. Maybe it'll kick in on the next possession. And that was Javon Young making it look easy, dropping two more points to make it a 12-point lead. Carter's got the ball. Gonzalez for two, just past the free throw line, and he gets a 6 point of the game. 10-point game again. It's interesting to see as you watch BCC play basketball, you never see the same team twice. You know, first game we saw a very dominant team. Second game we saw an in-and-out dominant team, and now this time, once again, we're seeing that kind of in-and-out team. Not the same defense being ran, nothing. Gonna get the foul. He's gonna go to the line. So, Gomes gets the basket. He racks up his ninth point of the game. He's going to shoot one more. If he hits that, it'll give him 10 points on the game. Get the shot, and it is good. That's 10 points so far for Jarrell Gomes. If he can catch fire in the second half, they can battle back from this. Foul on Nelson. Three fouls so far. Nelson a little frustrated with the foul, but the coach telling him, shut up, take it. Don't need to respond, you don't need to explain yourself. Now you rack up technical foul. Chantal Rodriguez can tell you from last Tuesday's game. Nelson with the steal. He almost wins the foot race. But not sure exactly what happened there, but the ball got pinned down. Bunker Hill recovers. And Young drains another three-pointer. He's got 5 points in the second half so far. Gomes dishes to Baker. Baker gets tied up with Stewart. And that's going to be Bunker Hill ball. On the jump ball. Oh, no, it's going to be BCC ball on the tie-up. BCC down by 12 with 2 minutes to go. 16 minutes to go in the second half. That's hard in the game a little bit on you, folks. That's Nelson for two. He's got 12 points on the game so far. Young dishes it in deep to Stewart. Stewart for two, and he gets it to go. He's got 6 points on this game so far. Gomes bringing it in. And after that, Aaron pass. Baker gets a foul and Bunker Hill ball. It'll be Baker's first foul of the quarter, of the half. But BCC already racking up four fouls in the early minutes of the second half. Rodgers with the ball. 14 points so far, looking for his first points in the second half. It's going to be BCC basketball. After Tron Griffith tries for a three, misses, and bounces off his hands and goes out of bounds. Tron Griffith so far, no points. Moves up and down the court, but really hasn't been able to put anything down. Gomes dishes it to Nelson, back to Gomes for three, and good. Jarrell Gomes making it look easy on that shot. We got a 9-point game right now, 60 to 51. They're calling a push on Jarrell Gomes. That's his, looks like fifth foul on the game so far. I could be lying though. I haven't been. Being a solo show, I'm not keeping the most accurate stats, to be honest. It's five team fouls for this half, and Gomes is going to check out. Rodriguez is going to check in for him. Just when I thought Gomes might be able to catch fire and really get the team motivated, he's going to sit down now because of fouls. Rodriguez is just as well can get them fired up. He scored 10 points off the bench in the first half, and shut him down under the basket. Rodgers shoots, misses, gets his own rebound, shoots it again, misses. Stewart gets it to go for two. BCC just can't fight their way in under the basket over there. They were getting boxed out very easily and very handily. There's four gray jerseys under that basket, and you can't have that on the defensive side. Baker tries to drive in. He draws a foul. And he's going to go to the line to shoot too. Fouls on David Stewart, the 6'4 forward from Madison Park Folk Tech. Racked up his, well, it's going to be his third foul of the game, if I'm not mistaken. Baker drains the first one easy. 1 more shot to go. If he hits it, it's a 9-point deficit. Coach Jalou calling plays. Bayhawk 2, not sure what it is, but we'll see what it looks like. And he misses the second one. Giraldi gets the rebound. So Baker gets one free throw. And now Nelson racks up another foul. So that puts Bunker Hill in the bonus very early in this game. Very early in the second half, I should say. And Tron for two, for three, can't get it to go. Rogers for three, can't get it to go. That rebound was by number 23. Can't find him on the, almost, it's actually gonna go to the line for two on that. That was Kevin Desire checking in. He got the rebound on that, turned it over, but then Bunker Hill turned it back over to him. Brings it the other way, and he racks up the foul. So Desire seeing his first few seconds of basketball, going to the line for two. This is his first one. He's got one more to go. Badu and Miller check in for Bunker Hill. Griffith and Giraldi are going to sit down and take a break. And Desire can't get either of them to go. BCC gets the ball back. Also checked in for BCC is Cody Hendricks. He's back in the game. So off that travel, BCC's got the ball back. 10-point deficit. Carter's got the ball. Back-to-back travels. Rodriguez racks up his own travel. And it's times like these that it hurts. You get the turnover on their travel to only turn around and travel yourself. Makes it all for naught, but Carter almost has the steal. Foul on the play. It's going to be a hold on Jeremiah Ephraim. And Bunker Hill takes the timeout. So 13:06 left to go in the second half. We just want to remind you to tune in to BCC Radio for the Dirty Water Sports Hour every Thursday at 4 o'clock on BCC Radio. You go to bccradio.org. You can check out the page. And you can also go to archive.org and search for the Dirty Water Sports Hour and listen to podcasts of our previous shows. Just wrapped up our Thanksgiving Day special today since we won't be able to get in the studio that day. So if you go to archives.org, look for Dirty Water Sports Hour, take a listen, you'll enjoy. So far this second half has not gone in BCC's favor at all. They started the second half down by 4, and now they find themselves down by 10, almost halfway through the second half. Once again, as I said, halftime, the keys to the game were going to be not turning the ball over, not making silly mistakes, and so far they've done both, and that's why they see themselves with a 10-point deficit. Bunker Hill came out of the gate early with a 6-0 run, put them up by 10. They took a timeout. They tried to rally the masses, but just wasn't happening. Holmes was just starting to catch fire. He got a couple more fouls. He had to sit back down on the bench. So see how long before he comes back out. BCC making their way back out onto the court. Right now we have number 23, Kevin Desire. Number 5, Steven Gonzalez. Number 24, Cody Hendricks. Dontel Rodriguez and Ryan Carter. Ball's in. Rodriguez brings it down court. We're at the 13-minute mark with a 10-point deficit for BCC. 62-52, Bunker Hill has the lead. Carter's got the ball. Hendricks puts up a deep three. Can't get it to go. BCC gets the ball back. And it's going to be a jump ball. Timeout, BCC. Quick thinking by Rodriguez to get the ball and call a timeout as he slid across the floor. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, and it's still going to be BCC ball. Real heads-up play by Rodriguez there to fall on the ball and call the timeout before he could get tied up and get the jump ball and have jump ball, because if I'm not mistaken, and most likely the reason he did it is because they are the possession arrow on a jump ball is in Bunker Hill favor. So we got this 30-second timeout. We got a score still of 62-52. Bunker Hill has the lead. And the teams make their way back out on the floor. The kid across the court plays with his little blinky ball. Inbounding the ball is going to be number 10, Ryan Carter. And the ref hands it off to him. Rodriguez passes off to Carter. Carter, poor passing choice, but it manages to get it to Monty Baker. Tied up. Right to black ball. Jump ball. Gives it to the Bunker Hill. Hence why that quick timeout was taken before, but now it's all for naught. Carter's going to bring up the ball. BCC showing that press defense that we haven't seen all game. See if it's going to make a difference now. And we got a foul. Desire picks up his first foul of the game. Actually, I think that might be his second foul. Nope. First foul of the game. We're going to shoot 1-1 because BCC's in the bonus. Scorekeeper fell asleep on the guest foul button because now they have... there we go. So he sunk the first one. Shoots one more. Crowd gets in his head. He can't get it to go. Shot and a miss, not sure who that's by. Calling a foul on. Got a foul on the play, not sure on who. Find out in a second from the ref. Technical foul, Ryan Carter, not sure what he did there, but that's never something you want to get. He's going to be sitting down for a while. Banks will be checking in for him. Probably won't see much more action for the rest of this game. Coach Delalue does not look very happy after that foul. That's number 3, Kevon Young. Hits 2 free throws off the technical. Gonna play a 3-2 defense, 3 up top, 2 down low. Zaire and Baker, 2 down low. 3 up top, Rodriguez. Hendricks and Bates. Got a 3 from Miller and he gets it to go. That's his second 3 of the game so far. He's got 6 points. And Zaire racks up his second foul. And they're going to go up to the line for 1-1. No, I lied. They're not going to the line for 1-1. Oh, no, actually, the foul was on number 12. It was on Stewart, and Stewart's going to take a seat. Not sure if he fouled out or not. Baker battles at the rim. Can't get the shot to go, but... Desire gets the rebound and gets it to go. That's his first 2 points of the game. He'll take away one of his fouls, give one to Stewart. I think he actually fouled that. It's going to be a travel, and that's going to be BCC ball. down by 14. This gives BCC a good opportunity. Gives BCC a good opportunity to battle back. 11:29 left to go in this game. They got a good chance to come back. They just need to get their heads in the game. And Rodriguez shoots an air ball from a mile away. And that's Young on the transition, trying to make something happen. Dishes it to the big man who can't get it to go. Surprised there was no foul calling out. That's Francois back in the game. He hit a three along the way. And on the transition, I missed who got that basket. I think it was Baker, actually. Badu's got the ball. Dishes it back to Young. Defense is starting to step up now, starting to get in the heads of Bunker Hill. Still fighting valiantly, but a couple of dish off, a couple of hands. Almost had a BCC steal there. They got numbers, and they got a foul. Rodriguez is going to go to the line to shoot two. Fouls on Sean Miller. That's, I think, his first foul of the game. Don't remember his number getting called for any fouls earlier. That puts them into the bonus, so they'll shoot one and one from here on out. Shoots his first one, and he misses. But Baker has the rebound. He loses control of the ball. Rebound by Young. Young almost loses control of the ball. He passes to Badu. Badu dishes it over to Dela Cruz, who's back in the game. Three for Young, and he makes it go. That's his fourth three of the game so far. And we got a 15-point lead, 71-56. And it's going to be a charge. And that's going to be Bunker Hill ball. Ball's back in bounds after the offensive foul. Dela Cruz brings it down court. Less than half of this half to go. 15-point lead for Bunker Hill, and now it's a 17-point lead. After two more points by Young. Young has just been a star on the court. He's just been on every end of every play. Once again, Young gets a hand on the pass. And Banks lets it go out of bounds. Coach Delalue not very happy with this team right now. Between foul trouble, turnovers, and more, it's this game's going downhill real quick. Bunker Hill is going to be out to a more substantial lead if they don't turn it around. BCC gets these sparks of ambition. Oh, Young with another 2 points. And he's going to go to the line for one more. Rodriguez picks up another foul. Rodriguez came off the bench on fire. And second half, he just can't get it together, much like the rest of the team. Coach Delalue already calling his third timeout in the first 11 minutes of this game, of this half, I should say. Because his team just can't get it together. They went from being down by 4 to now down by 19. With 9 minutes to go, it's very hard to battle back from a 19-point deficit. Not that it can't be done. If they can get it within 10 within the next five or so minutes. Now, if they give themselves a 10-point deficit with 5 minutes to go, that's a surmountable... That's surmountable, but otherwise it's, a couple more baskets, a couple more nails in the coffin, they're not going to be able to recover. Make matters worse, BCC already has 10 fouls, so this means from here on out they're going to be shooting. Every time they foul, Bunker Hill shoots too, because it's going to be easy points, so it means they cannot foul. They have no choice. They cannot foul. They've got to be play smart. Gotta keep their head in the game. Well, They already had a technical foul, which is another buzz kill. So right now on the court for BCC is Miguel Tejada, Cody Hendricks, Montel Rodriguez, Stephen Johnson Gonzalez, and Armani, nope, Chidi Amici. Young is going to shoot his plus one. See if he can hit it. Kid's been on fire all day, and he does. Makes it a three-point play and a 20-point lead for Bunker Hill. 9:13 to go, 76-56. If you're just joining us, Amici shoots three, doesn't get it. Bunker Hill rebounds. If you're just joining us, Bunker Hill and BCC have battled back and forth, changing the lead many a time during the first half. We ended the first half with a four-point deficit for BCC. And ever since then, Bunker Hill has controlled everything in this second half and now have a 20-point lead. There's an offensive foul on that play, so it turns the ball over to BCC. Amici's got it, looks for an open man. Montel gets in the lane. Bunker Hill knocks it out of Miguel Tejada's hands, goes out of bounds, and it's going to stay BCC basketball with 8:36 left to go and a 20-point deficit. Amici gets it in to Gonzalez. Gonzalez drives the lane, drops two, and it's good. Tracking up his eighth point of the game so far. Badu's got the ball, drives the lane, shoots it up and in. He's got 12 points on this game so far. He came off the bench and has really made a difference for this Bunker Hill team. He's been where he needs to be. He's made the baskets he's needed to make. Gonzalez gets the ball stripped away by Miller. Bunker Hill ball. And Miller brings it down court. He's at 2-3 so far. See if he tries to hit another one. Instead, he drives the lane. And there's a foul. Miguel Tejada racks up his second foul. And it looks like Bunker Hill going to the line to shoot two on that one. And right now, about to check in for BCC, we got Baker, Gomes, and Nelson to come in. Hopefully the big three can make a difference. Miller hits his first one. Amici, Rodriguez, and Tejada are going to take a seat. Gomes already racked up a decent amount of fouls. Hopefully he can keep himself out of trouble now that he's back on the court. Miller shoots his second free throw and nails it to bring them back to a 20-point lead. Sorry, a 22-point lead, 80-58. Nelson's got the ball. Finds the open man, Hendricks. Gomes racks up a three off the front rim. Rebound by De La Cruz. Dishes it to Young. Almost gets the two to drop, but he can't. Gomes on the rebound in the transition. Passes it too far out in front of Gonzalez. Turns the ball over. See the frustration on Coach Delalue's face in a play like that. You got the ball in the transition, and you just throw it out too far in front. That's going to be an offensive foul. That's going to be BCC basketball. De La Cruz gets the charge. 7:16 to go. 22-point lead for Bunker Hill. That's called for a travel. That's going to be another turnover. That's going to be Bunker Hill ball. The first half, you saw a lot of calls go BCC way. Now you've seen a lot of calls go Bunker Hill way in the second half. Well, what are they going to be able to do to get a spark to light up? Well, that's a good start. Turnover, BCC basketball with 6:50 to go. in a 22-point deficit. But if they can't bring, if they can't at least get this down to a 10-point lead with 3 minutes to go, then you know it's a 10-point deficit with 3 minutes to go. They're never going to be able to come back from this. Baker drives hard in the lane, but 2-on-1 is not in his favor. Rebound by Francois. Francois tries to drive the lane, dribbles it off his feet. Turnover, BCC basketball. BCC is getting the turnovers. BCC is getting the chances. They're not converting, and that was their problem last Thursday, and it's their problem again today, you know? They played one hell of a strong game Tuesday night against UCAP, but then they couldn't put up the same performance against Northern Essex. Northern Essex found their number. And Badu pulls off the three, but he can't make it fall. BCC basketball. Nelson has it. Hendricks tries to dribble in. He's met by the defense. Gomes is dead, met by a triple team. Dishes it to Baker for two. Imani Baker, and we haven't said too much tonight, puts two down. Benches Channing defense as De La Cruz puts up a three, misses it, and Baker gets the rebound. Nelson brings the ball back down court. He had 10 points in the first half of this game. Hopefully he can make it happen. Right now, Bunker Hill playing this two-man double team. And Gomes gets two to drop. Those are his two more points. Oh, they got the turnover. The easy basket from Nelson. Now the crowd's starting to come alive. They're down by 15 with 4:55 to go. Bunker Hill trying to make their way down court. Nelson trips over his own man. Now the BCC is playing their press defense. They're moving, putting pressure on him. Tron for three, can't get it to go. Almost another errant pass going out of bounds and another turnover. Luckily Gomes is able to reel it in. Hendricks has the ball. Gomes has it. Trying to get a man in there. Nelson's got the ball. Easy three. Can't get it to go. Almost misses the loses the rebound. Hendricks almost had it. Loses it. De La Cruz on the transition. Gets it to drop. Easy as pie. And he's got 4 points on the game so far. Haven't said his name much, but he does have 4 points. Holmes is getting a little fired up. Coach is telling him to calm down. And down by 17 with 4:03 to go in this game. And it's looking like this game is just about out of reach for BCC. Unless they can put on one of the most valiant comebacks in BCC basketball history. They battled back after a 20-point deficit last game against Northern Essex Community College. They were in within as little as three, but they just let the game get away from them with silly mistakes. Holmes is still chattering in the background while Coach Delalue is trying to rally the troops, but I think his night is just about done as well. We will see. Ball's going to be back in play in a moment. Interesting to see if BCC comes out in their full court press defense. I beg to wonder if they're not using it because Bunker Hill might have a little bit more speed on him. So that's BCC basketball with 4 minutes left to go in this game. BCC right now down by 17. Started battling back, but then Bunker Hill was able to get a basket in. Hendricks brings it down court. Looks to pass. Gets it to Nelson. Nelson dishes it to Amici. Bunker Hill almost steals it. And Nelson tries to dish it down low, the give and go, and the give and go was gone. Because the go never went. Bunker Hill ball with 3:41 to go in the game. Stewart, the shot, and it's good. Stewart goes from nothing to a lot. He's got 10 points in the second half. Hendricks to Amici for three, and he gets it to go. Gildy Amici puts his first three on the board. And he cuts the deficit. Deficit 16, if I'm reading this correctly. So it's a 16-point lead, and they can't get it to go. Banks drives it down. He doesn't have numbers, but he tries to get it to go, and he does! 4-on-1, and Banks gets it to go. That's his fourth point of the game, and he made that look easy. Got a 14-point deficit right now. Stewart underneath, he gets that to go. And he puts 12 on the board for himself now. Got a 16-point game right now. Hendricks with the ball. Nelson has it. In the corner is Banks. Oh, and they get the steal. Gonna slow it down. 2 minutes left. 2 minutes left, they're just gonna try and kill some clock. They got a comfortable 16-point lead. There's no need for them to risk it. But BCC needs to play some press defense. There's no way they're gonna be able to, and a good turnover off Giraldi's foot. Hendricks brings it back down, dishes it to Amici. Amici thought he was gonna go for the three. Why would you not go after that? Get and I think that spells the game, folks, right there. That's your ball game. Giraldi just put two more points up. And you let the ball go off your hands into the backcourt. You don't go after it, you just let it go. Another BCC turnover, Bunker Hill ball with 1:38 to go. Sad to say, folks, but this game is over. Bunker Hill trying to pass it in now when the game's well out of reach. BCC playing a full court press. They're in their, this is called their too little too late. Bunker Hill calls a timeout. Try to get reorganized. They weren't ready for a full court press. It looks like Elijah Rogers might be hurting a little bit. So they have a full timeout. Right now we got an 88-70 basketball game. Bunker Hill has an 18-point lead. BCC's well into the double bonus. They tried, but they just came out. They had a game that was once well in reach. They had a 4-point deficit coming into the second half. But, Bunker Hill won a 6-0 run, got a 10-point lead, then they built it to a 20-point lead, and BCC just hasn't been able to come back from that. And, you know, they can't keep the game close and then let it go after that. You know, they can't make silly mistakes. Can't, you know, errant passes, turnovers. You know, I've seen it two games in a row already, and, you know, the team that played against UCAP isn't the team I've seen the past two games. Got a game against Northern Essex. They just come off a game. You expect them to be a little tired after they played a hard-fought game. But, now they rack up another foul. Amici pulls the foul, and it's going to send Stewart to the line for two. Went from being non-existent to racking up 12 points so far in this. Hit two threes, and I'm looking at the wrong guy. He's hit 10 points a free throw. 10 points and a free throw. So 12 points total. He just hit his first free throw, so that's one more point. And Bunker Hill has the ball, and they're gonna call a foul. Not sure what the foul is. falls on Gonzalez. It's going to send Evan Bean, who I think this is the first time I've seen him in the game so far. Evan Bean's going to go to the line for two. Just getting a little practice time here as the game is out of reach. As well on the court for Bunker Hill is number 23, Demetrius Woodson, who we haven't seen yet. And, Stewart, Rogers, and Young. Well, sending the game otherwise. Nelson has the ball. Amici down low, shooting the three. Doesn't get it to go. Can't get the rebound. Bunker Hill ball with a minute to go and a 19-point lead. Rogers brings it down. Almost gets it stolen. Tron Griffith has the ball. Dishes to Demetrius Woodson, who puts up a three from downtown, well beyond the line, making it 92-70, a 22-point game. Banks tries to shoot two, can't get it to go. Bunker Hill's going to slow down the ball with 37 seconds left on the clock and a 22-point lead. And Banks draws the foul and sends Rogers to the line for two. He is a hurting puppy. He was limping off the court a little bit. Now he's holding his back. But he will go to the line for two. Well, not what we were expecting here, folks. BCC battled back and forth with Bunker Hill in the first half. They exchanged the lead back and forth repeatedly. BCC going, for a four to six point lead, and Bunker Hill going back to a 4-6 point lead back and forth. BCC was only down by four at the beginning of this second half, and Bunker Hill just took over in the second half. They outplayed them. They just played a smarter game. You know, they made their mistakes. They didn't play a perfect ball game by any means, but they still managed to keep their head above water for the entirety. And with 33.9 seconds left, there's a four-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. BCC going to try and make the scoreboard, make the deficit not look so big. Rodriguez for two, can't get it to go. Bunker Hill gets the ball. Shot clock is off. All they have to do is just run around. They just can dribble it out. 10 seconds to go in the game. De La Cruz has the ball. Had an open look. He's got 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. And that's your final score from the Bishop Connolly Gymnasium. The Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 94, your BCC Bayhawks 70. We'll be right back in just a moment with our post-game wrap-up right here on Fall River Community Media. Stay with us. This evening, your BCC Bayhawks fell to the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 94-70. BCC was down by four in the second half. They tried to battle back, but it just it didn't happen. Bunker Hill controlled the second half well, and it just wasn't meant to be. BCC only able to put up 29 points in the second half compared to the Bulldogs, who put up, if I can do some quick math here, they put up 49 points in the second half, so they outscored them by 20 in the second half. Some of the top scorers this evening: Kevon Young for Bunker Hill put up 24 points, hit four threes, and a couple of clutch free throws after hitting the basket, getting the extra point. David Stewart, after having a very quiet first half, came out in the second half, 13 points. Zachary Badu had 12 points, and Demetrius Woodson actually came off the bench at the end, hit a three from a mile away. For your Bayhawks, Joel Gomes, another guy who had a slow first half, second half came out, racked up 15 points total by the end of it. Josh Nelson and Dontel Rodriguez both racked up 12. Marnie Baker racked up a few points, getting 7 by the end of it all, and then Banks, Carter, and Cotton all kind of racking up 2 to 4 points. But otherwise, not what we had hoped for here, but Your BCC BayHawks are now 3-4 on the year. I think their next game coming up, if I'm not mistaken, is I would guess next Tuesday, since they won't be playing on Thursday since Thanksgiving. But that's going to do it for us here from the Bishop Connolly High School Gymnasium. Your final score, once again, your BCC BayHawks 70, Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 94. We'll talk to you again soon. I'm Ben Andrews signing off. Everyone, have a happy Thanksgiving. We'll see you next time.